Hey everyone, we're here at the Google Cloud Next Developer Zone. This is full of cool little showcases, hands-on labs, tutorials, and of course the DevZone stage, where people are able to come here and learn all about the cool things, but really get their hands on them and play around with them. Speaking of which, we're at the BQML station with Felipe Hoffa, who loves data and BigQuery. So Felipe, tell me a little bit more about what we're looking at here.
Hi Mark, so what we have here is a Stack Overflow predictor. How long will it take for people to answer your question?
So what does that mean specifically? So I can go into Stack Overflow, I can ask a question, but someone's not going to respond immediately.
Yeah, so I don't know if you ever ask a question on Stack Overflow. It takes some time, and you never know how long will it take.
Right.
Well, with this tool, we can kind of predict how long will it take, looking at all the past data that we have from Stack Overflow.
Now, how do you do that? Because BigQuery, you can do a bunch of data analysis, but you can't build a machine learning model in BigQuery, right?
Well, you can now. So I love BigQuery, I love data analytics. Thanks to the public data program, we have a copy of Stack Overflow, the dump that they publish every quarter. So we loaded that in BigQuery, and then you can start running your own SQL queries over it. Anyone can come and run any query they want. They have a free terabyte every month. So the first step with data analytics is just to look at all your questions, look at all your answers, and get an average of how long did it take for people to answer questions on Stack Overflow.
So people can come here to the next showcase floor, play around with this interface here, change and see if they ask a question, and then based on the machine learning model, they'll see about how long they'd have to wait for someone to go in and answer it.
Exactly. So how did we go from the analytics of just average group by to a prediction? There's a lot of spaces in between. Like, for example, to get an answer for the Google BigQuery tag at 8 a.m. for a medium question that ends with a doesn't end with a question mark, that starts with a Y. For someone that created an account in 2017, we're predicting that it will take 53 minutes. Maybe they will not get an answer, but with an 85% of probability, they will get one. And there is a chance of being downvoted of about a 7% for these statistics. Now, how did we build this? We created a linear regression using all of these features and the data that we had available.
So with all this different information, you can know when you ask a question, approximately, hopefully pretty relatively, when it's going to be answered, but you could also maybe even predict when's the best time to ask a question.
Exactly, if you want to go the opposite way, so let's say it takes 53 minutes on a Tuesday, on Sunday, it takes more like an hour to get an answer. But there's a higher chance of getting an answer.
So lots of cool information to play around with here, but people can also come here and actually learn BQML hands-on, right?
Exactly. So there are two alternatives. For people that are not here, to see how I made this, they can go to my blog post on Medium, just search for Felipe Hoffa, when will Stack Overflow reply? And if you are here at Next, we have code labs ready for you to run that you can also find online. But there's many ways to learn and get your hands into these tools.
Perfect. So lots of cool stuff from BQML. Come down to the floor, get started, or check out the resources online.